गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर थर्ड सेमेस्टर इलेक्ट्रिकल स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज आईसी इंजन. द टर्म आईसी इंजन मींस इंटरनल कंबशन इंजन. द टर्म आईसी इंजन इज अप्लाइड टू ऑल इंजन्स हैविंग कंबशन ऑफ द फ्यूल टेकिंग प्लेस इनसाइड द इंजन सिलेंडर एंड द वर्किंग मीडियम कंसिस्ट ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ combustion of the air fuel mixture itself. The most application of IC engines are aeroplanes, locomotives, etc. Terms used in an IC engine. First of all, I will discuss what is bore. The inside diameter of the working cylinder is known as bore. Another definition of bore is the inner diameter of the cylinder in which the piston moves is known as bore. This is the model of four-stroke petrol engine. This is the bore. The inner diameter of the working piston in which the piston moves is known as bore. Then I will discuss what is dead center. The another terms are top dead center and bottom dead center. In this model, this is the top dead center. That means when the piston is at topmost, that is cylinder head is known as top dead center. What is BDC? When the piston is at nearest to the crankshaft, that is known as BDC, that is known as bottom dead center. What is stroke length? The distance traveled by the piston when it moves from TDC to BDC is known as stroke length. It is measured in millimeter. Then another point is clearance volume. This is the clearance volume. When the piston is at top dead center, there is some volume or gap between piston and cylinder head is known as clearance volume. In this figure, this is the connecting rod, this is the crankshaft, crank pin, this is the flywheel, this is the inlet valve, this is the outlet valve, this is the carburetor. Now, I will another terms used in an IC engine are stroke volume or swept volume, that is VS. When the working piston is moving from TDC to BDC, the volume is created, that is known as swept volume. Mathematically, it is written as VS. VS is equal to A into L. AL is equal to piston area and L is equal to stroke length, and it is given by pi by 4 d square L. Then what is cylinder volume? It is the sum of clearance volume and swept volume. It is given by Vs plus Vc. Then what is compression ratio? It is the ratio between total cylinder volume to clearance volume. Mathematically, it is written as R is equal to total cylinder volume divided by clearance volume is equal to BC plus VS by PC. Then another term is piston speed. You know that piston speed? Now another term is piston speed. Piston speed means the distance traveled per unit time. Here, the distance traveled by the piston per unit time is known as piston speed. It is given by the formula 2L N meter per second. L is equal to stroke length and N is equal to RPM, that is revolution per minute. Now, Mr. Ashutosh sir will explain the working principle of four-stroke petrol engine.
Welcome students, now I will demonstrate the four-stroke petrol engine. Now look at the diagram. Here it is the diagram of four stroke petrol engine. Okay, four stroke petrol engine. Students, it is also called as SI engine. SI engine means spark ignition engine. Means ignition takes place by the help of spark plug. Now look here, this is your cylinder. This is your cylinder and this is your piston. This is your connecting rod and this is your crank. Here you have IP means inlet valve and here you have exhaust valve. Okay, here spark plug is placed in between inlet valve and exhaust valve. Now I will explain the different four strokes are according four stroke petrol engine. Okay, so first I will write the stroke. Now students, as it is a four stroke, okay students, as it is a four stroke, so means obviously there will be four strokes happening in this four stroke petrol engine. So first I will discuss what is stroke. What is stroke? Stroke means it is the up down motion of the piston. Stroke means it is the up or down motion of the piston. Now the name suggests it is a four stroke, means piston will move four times, either upward or downward. Let our piston is at, this is my TDC, this is our BDC. Let our piston is at TDC, means top dead center. Top dead center, now piston will move downward from TDC to BDC. Means what I said, stroke means it is the upward or downward motion of the piston. As the piston moves from TDC to BDC, it will complete one stroke and that stroke is known as your suction stroke. So here I am writing the stroke. Here I am writing the stroke and the stroke is your suction. Okay? And along with I am writing the crank angle and the valves, that is inlet valve and exhaust valve. Now students, look what is the working principle of suction stroke, how it happens. When the piston moves from TDC to BDC, it completes one downward motion, means one stroke is completed, means first suction stroke is completed. And when piston moves from TDC to BDC, the crank will rotate 180 degrees. Here total angle will be 360 degrees, means crank will rotate half part, means 180 degree rotation of the crank will give you one stroke, that is your suction stroke. And in suction stroke, when the piston moves downward, a suction pressure or vacuum pressure is created inside the engine cylinder. And in your outside there is atmosphere pressure. As there is pressure difference created, so what happens? Charge means the mixture of petrol and air, or air-fuel mixture. Now charge will enter due to the suction stroke. Okay, after completing the suction stroke, the piston again moves from what? BDC to TDC, means there is an upward motion of the piston. Motion means stroke. Upward motion means one stroke. First suction is completed, then after suction stroke, there is a compression stroke. What happens? There is a compression stroke. In compression strokes, the both valves, inlet valve and exhaust valve, is closed. This is closed. And in suction stroke, our inlet valve opens but exhaust valve closed. Okay, it is not opening. And in second stroke, both it is closed and it is closed. Now the piston, when piston moves from BDC to TDC, it will try to compress what? It will try to compress the charge, that is air fuel mixture. And after the compression completes, when the piston reaches the highest position, that is TDC, there is a spark plug. Here is spark plug. Now spark plug activated and it will spark. It will spark and due to the help of that spark, the charge ignites. And that's why it is called as spark ignition engine. Why ignition takes place due to the help of spark. Now as the spark created after compression, the temperature and pressure of the charge is so much high that by coming contact with the spark, it will ignite and the piston will feel very high pressure, and another stroke is created, that is our power stroke, okay, or expansion stroke. So this is our expansion stroke. Okay, this is the most important stroke. Without this stroke, the engine cannot run. This is also known as what? Power stroke. As stroke created means now piston will move. Stroke means it is the downward or upward motion. Means power stroke mein kya hoga? Tumhara piston it will go downward. It will complete one stroke. And in one stroke, piston again covers 180 degree. And here also in compression, when compression takes place, piston also moves from BDC to DC and crank rotates again 180 degree. And here also crank rotates 180 degree. And in expansion stroke also, both the inlet valve closed and exhaust valve closed. Now students, when expansion strokes completes, means all the bond, all the gases, all the charge, all the inlet charge have burnt. Now the due to inertia, the piston will force all the bond gases via exhaust valve. Now this stroke is known as exhaust stroke. This stroke is known as exhaust stroke, and again in exhaust stroke the crank will rotate 180 degree. And now in exhaust stroke your inlet valve is closed. Here inlet valve is closed, but exhaust valve opens. And by opening the exhaust valve, all the residual gases or bond gases are coming out from the engine cylinder, and the next new cycle will be started. I am again explaining what happens. First stroke is your suction stroke, means piston moved from TDC to PDC. In suction, crank rotation is 180 degree. In suction stroke, inlet valve opens, exhaust valve closed. Clear? After completing the suction, the piston, after completing suction, the charge enters in the cylinder and piston compresses the charge. Means piston, after compression, the crank rotation will be 180 degree. In compression stroke, both valves are closed. After compression completed, there is a spark ignited by the spark plug. Due to spark, the charge will ignite and it will force the piston to downward. That is our main power stroke. That is expansion stroke. And in expansion stroke, the crank also rotates in 180 degree. And in this stroke, both the valves are closed. And final stroke is your exhaust stroke, where the piston will force all the bond gases outside the engine cylinder. And in that case, the crank will rotate 180 degree and exhaust valve opens and inlet valve closed. Now the important concept, look here students. When suction and compression completes, the total rotation of the crank, here crank rotation is 180 degree, here also crank rotation is 180 degree, so total rotation is 360 degree. 360 degree means total one revolution, means it will cover one revolution. Suction plus compression means one revolution. One revolution means ek chakkar. In one revolution, suction and compression completes. Now come here, in expansion, crank rotation is 180 degree. In exhaust, crank rotation is also 180 degree. So total rotation of crank in expansion and exhaust is also 360 degree. Means again one revolution. Again one revolution. यहाँ पे हमारा था क्या? पहले एक revolution हो गया था suction compression में. यहाँ पे power stroke और exhaust में एक revolution हो गया. So what is the total revolution? 1 + 1, it is 2 revolution of the crankshaft. Means the cycle will be completed after 2 revolution of the crankshaft. So it is also known as 2 revolution 4 stroke SI engine. Now I will see here, I want to show you. Now students look here, this is the flywheel, okay, this is the engine cylinder, this is the piston, and this part is your connecting rod, and this is your crank, okay, this is your crank. The pin where connecting rod and piston connects, it is known as piston pin or Gaussian pin. And the pin, look here, and the pin where connecting rod and crank connected, it is known as a crank pin. This is your crankshaft, where crank is placed. Now I am starting from TDC. So this is my top dead center, where piston moves highest position. So what happens when piston moves downward, TDC to BDC, this is my inlet valve, it will open. And from this intake manifold, all air fuel mixture will come into the engine cylinder due to suction, due to negative pressure. Then piston moves from BDC to TDC. This is second stroke. Now crank rotation is 180 degree again. Now both valves are closed and the charge will compressed. After that, there is a spark plug here. this is spark plug. From this it will spark, and due to that spark it will ignite the charge, and a power stroke will be created, and piston will feel a pressure. Due to that pressure piston go downward and it move to TDC to BDC, and after completion of the power stroke all the bond gases will be exhausted out via this exhaust manifold and exhaust valve in the exhaust stroke, and cycle will be completed. Now look here, from TDC to BDC suction, BDC to TDC compression, this is total one revolution, 360 degree. Again, from power stroke to exhaust stroke, again one revolution, means it will complete two revolution. So this is all about, students, your four stroke petrol engine. Okay, I think the concept will be clear. Thank you.